like that one?
Oh, yes.
That's nice.
Just chatting it up. Actor and producer Josh Hartnett first became a Hollywood heartthrob when he played Trip Fontaine, the too cool for school teen, in one of my favorite movies of all time, The Virgin Suicides. He's then had our hearts racing when he played Captain Danny Walker in the war epic Pearl Harbor.
Well, now Josh has made his way back to the small screen for the Showtime series Penny Dreadful, and he plays an American helping to vanquish evil spirits in London, who happens to be hiding a secret of his own, apparently. Josh, good morning.
Hey, Josh.
Morning.
Morning.
Good to see you guys.
So, spoiler alert for those who haven't been following along, the secret you've been hiding is you're a werewolf.
I'm a werewolf.
But you're not aware that you're a werewolf. How's that happen?
You're an unawarewolf.
I'm an unawarewolf. Yes. Nice. I haven't heard that before. That's fantastic. Yeah. No, he doesn't know that he's a werewolf, but he knows that things are happening with him that obviously he blacks out. He wakes up, things have gone incredibly wrong in his vicinity, and he's just trying to kind of put together what it is he is, because at that time there was no lore about werewolves. He didn't know what you know, what he is, no concept of what he could be. But that's what this season's about. We're figuring out who he is.
Cool.
So Josh, for people who may just be coming to Penny Dreadful, it's a freaky, and I use that word as a great thing, show. Paint the picture. What's the backdrop of this world you all have created?
Well, it's Victorian London, so like 1890s in London, and a lot of the characters are taken from Victorian horror literature, and they're all kind of treated as real people living in London at the same time, and they all bump into each other. They all sort of know each other, and you know, craziness ensues.
I mean, this is a horror. I mean, a horror genre. I mean, really, in the true sense of the word. Are you attracted to that?
Well, it wasn't necessarily the genre that attracted me. It was because John Logan, who's written everything from Skyfall to The Aviator to Gladiator, decided he was gonna write this show. And Sam Mendes produced it, who's directed American Beauty, Skyfall again. And this great director named J.A. Bayona, who's really coming up, was directing the first few episodes. And so I thought, these are amazing collaborators to work with. And if you're going to do TV, you want to work with people who are going to be consistently giving you good material. Mm-hmm. So that's more of the reason why I did it.
You seem so thoughtful in the roles that you select. And I recently read something about Batman. Is it not true? Tell me what's going on here. Did you turn down Batman?
No, I think that story just got kind of blown out of proportion, because sometimes, you know, when things go from your mouth to the page and then through the blogosphere, it ends up being like a good bad game of telephone, you know what I mean? Back in, you know, 2002 or 2003, I had a meeting with the director who I thought I should have formed a relationship with, and I liked a script that he had that his brother had written, and he ended up doing that next, and I said to him at the time, like, I really want to do this. I mean, we were talking about Batman, but I didn't really want to, it wasn't what I was interested in. And I just said in that interview that I thought I should have formed that relationship, and now knowing more about Hollywood now, I would have definitely done anything to kind of stay in that relationship and make, you know, multiple films, doesn't matter what they are.
So it's all lies.
It's just a reinterpretation of the truth.
But you keep really busy, it seems, with directing and producing as well. Do you prefer that to acting?
It's much less nerve-wracking to be behind the camera, I have to say. I like to be a little bit more in control, you know, and here I'm giving up all control to you guys, and whenever I'm on screen,
we got nothing to do with it, the power's sit
behind the camera, you know. I like both, obviously. Yeah.
Josh Hartnett, thanks so much, and Penny Dreadful airs Sundays on Showtime.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.